Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Caden Gray. Some things you might not know about me is actually I'm a huge softie. Really, I just want this like long-term boyfriend to go away to the country, get some kittens.
What are you doing?
Abuse me with the hat.
Hey guys, this is Caden, the real one, and I'm here with Tina, who's also part of Impulse. I don't know if you've seen her face, you may have seen her hijacking my Instagram before. What do you do for Impulse?
Nothing.
Nothing. Okay, settled. Token lesbian. And this is exactly why she's here, because she's a lesbian. And I'm gay, in case you didn't know. And homosexuality, yeah, whatever. Like, it's the 2017.
I thought this was a date.
Homosexuality has been one of the most confusing things for me throughout my life, and one of the most defining, even though I don't think that, you know, I'm just gay. There's so many other things to me. And there was a time at the Impulse launch. We went to get cigarettes at some point. We snuck out and she said something, like I said something, and she went, you went, I'm a top, right? And I thought to myself, like how can a girl be a top? She doesn't have a dick. Do you have a dick?
Sometimes.
Okay. We wanted to do a video about gender stereotypes. We've been wanting to do it for a while, and I think she's the perfect person to do it with. I've been thinking up a structure for this video because I didn't want us to just babble for an hour. This is not gonna be an hour. Like, I'm gonna cut it down to 2 minutes. I'm pretty good at that. She won't even be in it. So I've written a couple of things down to help us through this. And let's start with the childhood.
Rewind.
Okay, so when you were little,
mm-hmm.
Did you play with girls? Did you?
No.
What kind of toys did you have?
I had girls.
What kind of sports were you into? All those kind of.
When I was very, very young, like, you know, when you don't really have an identity, you're just a gendered kid, so you buy them Barbies and stuff. So I had all the Barbies. And then when
you
I was.
Did.
I did have Barbies. I did actually like Barbies. Like, I didn't do with Barbies what other girls did with Barbies. I use them as action men. I take them outside and cut their hair off and that kind of stuff.
That's what my brother did.
Yeah, because I was
also gay, by the way.
He's gay too?
Yeah.
Oh my god!
He's not that much younger than me either, so like.
So you got it from you?
Because you can catch gay, you know that. I've never had sex with my brother, I just want to put it out there.
But it's like, it's sort of learned behaviour. You don't have to like, have sex with your brother, and let's just cut that.
No, I think we knew certain things about each other, but we didn't understand what homosexuality was. Like, I got bullied shit ton before I even ejaculated for the first time.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like, people assumed I was gay before I knew, because I wasn't gay as a kid, but I only had boyfriends. We climbed trees, played PlayStation. I had girlfriends at school, because I think at school you had gendered groups. All the boys hung around together, all the girls hung around together. But outside of school, my best friend was a boy, and we had the best. There was never any awkwardness. I never for a second thought that we fancied each other. And I guess that should have been a flag. And for, I looked very boyish, my fashion and everything.
Well,
I
past tense.
Hey, I remember when I knew I was gay, I just started going really girly, painting my room pink and everything. But yeah, as a kid, I wasn't gay. Yeah, I was like, oh, no, I'm not even liberated. I was like, I'm a girl, I'm not gay. I'm going to hide it by painting my room pink.
Oh, so was it that
yeah,
was that?
It was to hide it, not to feel liberated. As soon as I realised I started to like girls, I was like, okay, I need to act more like a girl and then maybe I won't be gay.
Fuck, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, but then as soon as I was comfortable with it.
What age was that?
Oh, when I knew I liked girls. About 14.
Had you had sex by then? Like
14?
A sexual encounter?
Oh, no. The first time I lost my virginity to a guy, I was 16, and I lost my virginity to a girl at 17, I think.
Well, I think, I hate to tell you this, but by the time you met her, you'd already lost your virginity.
Oh, girl. I was
If you had a penis, It was all over.
I knew what an orgasm was before I had sex with someone. So I knew that when I had sex with a guy, that was not hitting it.
Okay.
Yeah.
So do you think you actually knew your sexuality before you had sex?
Oh yeah. Yeah, definitely.
You did?
Yeah, but I there was room for hope before I had sex with someone. So like I knew I liked girls, I just hoped I could like both, or at least hoped I could pretend. Like it wasn't so traumatic and so horrible, that, and it wasn't traumatic, but I was hoping that the sex wasn't so crappy that I could pretend to enjoy it for the rest of my life, so that I wouldn't ever have to come out as gay. And it wasn't like every guy I had sex with, I'm really lucky, like they were really lovely, but...
How many do you want to say?
Oh, nope.
Yeah, let's not. Because if we're going to show that, then everyone's going to have a shocker. You know that I'm...
No, it wasn't a huge number. It was under 10.
Then we have nothing in common, basically. Yeah. We're completely different people.
Well, that's the point.
That's why she's here, really.
To make you feel bad about your sexual choices.
Yeah, but I mean, you know, I'm joking about this, right? Like, I actually think slut shaming is one of the worst things.
Oh, for sure. I've had sex with a lot more women. That's fine.
But you see, that's the thing. It's the same for guys. Like, to be fair, I think society doesn't care a lot of the time when two women get off with each other, because straight men like it, and women aren't that judgmental. I don't think women are so power oriented. Women don't care for that so much. They're more into nurture than domination and power. So, but back to what I was saying a moment ago, when you have sex with a woman, you're not a slut.
I've got a dead leg, I'm sorry.
But if you're a girl or a gay guy and you have a lot of sex, you get basically when you get fucked, when you get penetrated, then you're a slut.
Really?
Well, that's what I'm getting.
That's sexism to me. That's anything that's related to like the women's side. You get shamed for, but if you're being like a masculine, boisterous fucker,
then everyone will high five.
That's sexism.
By everyone, I mean other straight men will high five. This is why I think in porn, female actors, porn stars, earn more than anyone else. Mm-hmm. Then you have gay guys, and then you have straight guys, with some exceptions, obviously. But to be fair, like a lot of the time in porn, the straight guy is. No one cares about him. Because guys watch it.
Yeah, half the time they don't even show their face. Like, I've noticed with porn.
That's very true,
you see the
woman
or whatever, with the guy sometimes you're literally
she's
just
the star.
Dick.
She's like the only thing that matters there.
Because I guess a lot of more men, they assume, consume porn. So they almost want a man to feel like he is that penis, I guess, maybe.
Yeah, well, I think there's obviously a variety, because I was straight porn, and there's many other gay... Yeah, there you go. So today it's very mixed, but like in the past, I didn't think porn was that big. And for a girl to do porn would mean that she would be socially scrutinized. Mm. So it's there's a lot at stake. So not as many girls do porn as men would want to. Because a man can go and fuck a girl and they'll be like, yeah, good times, man. Well done.
Yeah, it's like, oh, look at you fucked.
Yeah.
And then with a girl, it's like...
And it translates to the gay community. Like, by gay, I mean gay guys, right?
Mm.
If you're a top... A lot of the time people won't call you out on the fact that you're promiscuous, if you are. Excuse me. And if you're a bottom, you'll get shamed, like if not in London, then other parts of the country and the world. Even with guys that are seemingly open-minded, you still get that. Like among friends, there's gonna be the teasing, all kinds of names. You call each other names for the fact that you take dick.
I guess we have those kind of names in the lesbian community, but you wouldn't get you get shit for being lazy. So we have this thing like called
lazy.
Yeah, like pillow princesses and so.
What princesses?
Pillow princess. It means you just lay there and take it.
Is that a term?
Yeah, pillow princess.
Hashtag this.
I don't think that's just in the lesbian community either. I just think it's used a lot by us. But there's no
pillow
shame
princess.
Whether you're a bottom or a top. We don't really have that, actually. Everything's quite versatile. When I said I was a top that time, like, I was just being very promiscuous. So I was like,
I was being more
masculine. Yeah, I was just being more going out there and stuff. But I think every lesbian that I've ever been with is versatile. Like, you take it in turns. That's how it is. But there's never any shame. There's just like teasing with the whole, oh, you're a pillow princess, you're a chapstick, and all that kind of stuff.
What's a chapstick?
Chapstick is, so it's a lipstick lesbian who wears makeup and looks very feminine, wears dresses, that kind of stuff.
Oh!
Myself.
Well, I think you're kind of like a hybrid, right?
I'd be like a chapstick because I'm wearing like ripped jeans.
Oh, fuck off, you're wearing a matte coral lipstick.
It's matte.
An eyeliner. You're not a chapstick, are you?
No, but I wear makeup, but a chapstick is more like they wear makeup, but they also...
It always looks like there's nothing on, like, oh, like, kind of bare?
No, nothing about makeup. Like, lipstick lesbian is like feminine everything. Like, lipstick does their hair, wears dresses, and chapstick is like, yeah, I care about my hair, I do my face, but I also wear boyish style clothes,
kind of
actionist
like
clothes.
Person before... The rest?
It's in between. It's like lipstick, chapstick, butch. Oh, there's probably more. I'm not really the expert. But.
You see, I think butch lesbians are the ones that everyone talks about most. Because you obviously notice when a girl is masculine, she's wearing a khaki shirt and loose jeans and like high tops or boots or something.
Yeah, everyone's got their
no
own.
Makeup, short hair.
When I came out as gay, like the first thing someone said to me was like, you're not going to shave your hair off now, are you? And I'd shaved my hair off when I was straight, for God's sake. Oh, straight. But I was like, no, I'm not going to change how I look now because I've come out. Like, there's this idea there's a look to a lesbian. And also, I'm attracted to those kind of girls as well. Like, I like women.
So not just those kind of girls?
No, yeah, yeah. I mean, I go through phases, I guess. Sometimes I need something more masculine from someone, and I need something from that, and other times I'm like, oh, I like this.
I think that's a good way to balance it.
Yeah.
I've gone through phases, but it's usually... I think I'm pretty settled now, so I usually like the same kind of experience, not the same kind of guy, because I obviously don't like certain extremes in myself and other men.
Ooh.
But I think that comes from the fact that I've been shamed for it. Like, when I was young, I was being called a faggot because, yeah, I was a camp boy. I was young and small, and people really picked on me.
Yeah.
Funny enough,
one look of at the, this heart of you now.
I know, right? Check this out. And the funny thing is, like, I had experiences from like a very young age. I think age 6, I think, which isn't talked about. Like, if I was to do a porn interview, I'm not allowed to say that because it doesn't happen. The people who produce porn, they're bound by some really severe, exaggerated licensing.
Mm.
And so you don't talk about these things because obviously then it's porn after all. People look at porn for the sexual entertainment. The people don't care about being educated by it, actually. So when you say 13 or whatever, they're like, oh no, then say, just say you're 18.
Actually, I had, like, I don't want to come around, but
yeah,
like,
you
I had
see?
Some, well, I had some experiences when I was like between 6 and 8. Like,
there you go, like rubbing something.
Yeah, exactly. It wasn't like
doctors
sex,
and nurses.
It was pretty fucking close, yeah, because he was just like,
that's what I mean.
You have something different, and yeah.
Let's check it out.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
Yeah, so I mean, I knew that we had the same thing with the boys because there were actually two brothers. And I had every last one of them. No, but like we we started playing
did
around.
You live in a small town.
Cause yeah,
that's why. Because like, you're bored, isn't it?
I'm surprised I didn't fuck my brother. To be fair, because I mean, he's a riot, no? Cut! Cut!
Get off my beard.
My girlfriend, like I had a really big girlfriend that I married. A lesbian with a good lipstick. Who knew?
It was bought for me for my birthday.
Obviously, people cast me to play a certain character. Dominant top, whatever. Gay guys, when they say lesbian, they like, it's like saying...
I invited Satan.
Yeah! But I actually used to think I had a small dick. Do you like rosé?
No.
Okay. That's the thing, because I like a big dick. I'm a cliché.
I like red wine, but I didn't want to have wine lips at 2 p.m.
So I waited for you to say no, because you're such a
just
confident
you have such
actor.
A huge dick.
Okay, well, here we go. That's it.